You're watching KCPT Kansas City.
Gentlemen, it's the Lawrence Welk Show, celebrating more than 50 years on television. Now sit back and enjoy the show, selected especially for public television.
Hello, everyone. I'm Mary Lou Metzger. Welcome to the Lawrence Welk Show. We're taking a tour of Southern California, and the year is 1982. We'll feature our singing trio, Gail, Ron, and Michael, with Pass Me By, and I get to drive the Aldridge sisters and the Otwell twins around the studio in a train. Speaking of the Otwells, Roger and David will be here at the end of this program to talk about their time on the show. But right now, here's that opening fanfare to kick things off.
From Hollywood, we bring you the Lawrence Welk Show. Now, here he is, Mr. Music Maker himself, Lawrence Welk.
Thank you, Bob. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Greetings, everyone, and welcome to a musical tour of Southern California. Starting with this land is your land. This evening. There's always been a strong Spanish and Mexican influence in Southern California. And here's the band with a song dedicated to all of our Spanish-speaking friends, CCC. Gentlemen, one and two and...
Uh. Welk, the band, champagne music in Latin style. In the Los Angeles area, the famous Knott's Berry Farm attracts many tourists from the East and Midwest. Ava Barber and Jim Turner welcome you to this popular park.
Now to Griffith Park in Los Angeles, where we find the Aldrich sisters and the Atwell twins doing a little California dreaming in the park's famous travel town.
Safe and warm.
If I was in L.A.
California dreaming. On such a winter's day.
Stopped into a church. I passed along the way.
Oh, I got down on my knees. And I began to pray. Preacher likes the cold. He knows I'm gonna stay.
California dreaming on such a winter's day.
All the leaves are brown and the sky is gray. I've been for a while. I'd be safe and warm. If I was in L.A. California dreaming. On such a winter's day.
Some tourists from Texas and Tennessee being given a good ride by Mary Lou Metzger. One of the many attractive features of Southern California is its mild year-round climate. Right now we find Bobby and Elaine at one of the area's beaches, enjoying the water, the weather, and the sights.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you all so very much. For years, movie fans have been fascinated by Hollywood Boulevard. Landmarks include the Hollywood Walk of Fame and the footprints in front of the Chinese Theater. Arthur Duncan and some of our pretty girls make a stroll along this famous street. Known for its relaxed lifestyle. This next song by Gail, Ron, and Michael might express the attitude of some local people.
I've got me 10 fine toes to wiggle in the sand. Lots of idle fingers step to my command. A lively pair of heels that kick to beat the band. Can be fascinating. Add to these a nose that I can thumb and a mouth by gum. Have I to tell the whole darn world? If you don't happen to like it, deal me out. Thank you kindly. Pass me by, pass me by, pass me by. If you don't happen to like it, pass me by.
I got me two great shoes that never saw.
Trousers I can hold up with the laundry line.
A lovely patch that hides an awful lot of spine.
Shirt tails flying, well, I'm a blooming dandelion. Add to these a grin from ear to ear, and all the proper gear have I to tell the whole darn world. If you don't like the assortment, deal me out. Thank you kindly, pass me by. Pass me by.
What a talented trio! And they've been such great assets to our show. Now let's join Guy and Rolla at one of the busiest places in the country, the Los Angeles International Airport.
Faraway places, strange sounding names. Far away over the sea, those far away places where the strange sounding names are calling, calling me.
I'm going to China on Mavis I am. I want to see for myself those faraway places I've been reading about in a book that I took from the shelf.
I start getting restless whenever of a train. I long for the day I can get underway and look for those castles in Spain. They call me a dreamer. Well, maybe I am. I know I'm burning to
music lovers from all over the world enjoy concerts in the beautiful Hollywood Bowl. And here's a sample of the kind of music you might hear at the Bowl. The familiar 1812 overture, arranged by Bob Ballard and conducted by George Cates.
Wow. The 1812 Overture was also an exciting crowd pleaser on our road trips. Our tour of Southern California continues with Anna Connie singing Cielito Lindo and Norma Zimmer with a thrilling performance of The Sound of Music. And remember, I'll be visiting with the Otwell twins at the end of our program. But now back to the show.
Ladies and gentlemen, our first steady job in Southern California was in 1951 when we played at the Aragon Ballroom in Ocean Park. And here's a song we featured quite often in those days, I've Told Every Little Star. Gentlemen, one and two and...
Champagne music. And Lawrence, we have a very special guest on our stage this evening, a gentleman you've known for many, many years, and I believe he has a few words to say to you. Here's the president of Los Angeles Local 47 of the American Federation of Musicians, Mr. Max Herman.
Thank you, Mike. Thank you. Yeah. Lawrence, on behalf of the officers and board of directors of the Hollywood Musicians Union, and 16,000 of the world's greatest musicians, I'm honored to be with you tonight to present to you a little token of our appreciation, what you have done for music and the live musician. And I'd like to read it to all our friends. In appreciation to Lawrence Welk for the contribution you have made to the enrichment of world musical life and for your activities in furthering the presentation of live music. God bless you.
Well, thank you so very, very much. Isn't that nice? Isn't that nice? Thank you so very much. Let me give you a big hug. Thank you very, very much. On behalf of all of our musicians, we indeed appreciate this very, very
thank
much.
Thank you very much, Lawrence.
Thank you. Now on with the show, Kathy Sullivan and Dick Dale offer this salute to the world champion, Los Angeles Dodgers.
Will everyone here kindly step to the rear and let a winner lead the way?
Here's where we separate the notes from the noise,
the men from the boys,
the rose from the poison. I'll be back in the bunch. I came up with the hunch. This was an up and Adam day.
It's one of those spells when you hear the right bells,
and your horoscope tells you to say,
will everyone here kindly step to the rear and let a winner
everyone here kindly step to the rear
and let a winner lead the way.
Here's where we separate the duck from the quack,
the ace from the pack,
the pip from the Macintosh is back in the group. I came up with the scoop. This was the time to rise and say,
I've got in my eye such a jubilant sky
that the 4th of July will seem great.
Will everyone here kindly step to the rear and let a winner lead the way?
Thank you all so very, very much. What a beautiful studio audience we have with us this evening. Well, it looks like I'm going to have a chance to play with two of the world's greatest accordionists, Myron Florin and Joey Schmidt, and this song from our new three-accordion album. It's the theme of a famous tourist attraction, Disneyland. It's a small, small world.
You know, next to the polka, here's a song that happens to be a special favorite of our boss, La Vie en Rose. And it features our wonderful clarinet man, Henry Cuesta, and all the champagne music makers. Boss, it's your band. Take it away.
Thank you. dejando un par de ojitos negros, cielito lindo de contrabando, por la sierra morena vienen bajando, vienen bajando un par de ojitos negros, cielito lindo de contrabando. Ay, 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 canta y no llores, porque cantando se alegran, cielito lindo, los corazones. Pájaro que abandona su primer nido, regresa y ya no encuentra, cielito lindo, el bien perdido. Ese lunar que tienes, cielito lindo, junto a la boca, no se lo des a nadie, cielito lindo, que a mí me toca. Ay, 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 canta y no llores, porque cantando se alegran, cielito lindo, los corazones.
Pretty music from Anacani, Lee Levang, and Richard Maloof. While we're down Escondido way, let's pay a visit to one of Lawrence's favorite spots, the golf course. It seems that the local golf pro, Jack Immel, has a few tips for Mary Lou Metzger.
Say, that's some swing you got there.
Would you believe this is the first time I ever even held a golf club?
You're kidding. I understand you've signed up for golf lessons.
Oh, well, I probably could use a little improvement.
Well, you know, it's all in the swing. You see, it don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing.
It don't mean a thing. All you gotta do is swing.
That's right. It makes no difference just how hard the shot.
Just give that rhythm everything you've got.
Right on!
It don't mean a thing if it ain't got that swing.
The hills around Escondido make a beautiful backdrop for our lovely champagne lady, Norma Zimmer. Let's listen to Norma and the title song of the wonderful show, The Sound of Music.
sound of music, with songs they have sung for a thousand years. The hills fill my heart with the sound of music. My heart wants to sing. Like the wings of the birds that rise from the lake to the trees, my heart wants to sigh like a chime that flies from a church on a breeze, to laugh like a brook as it trips and falls over stones on its way to sea.
Take you to Santa Anita Racetrack for a little fun with Ken D'Elo and the Hotsy Totsy Boys. At the track, boys. There are many beautiful places in Southern California and all over the United States. And here's our choir with a tribute to our great country.
so glad you could be with us for our tour of Southern California. My special guests are the twin brothers with the velvet voices that we all fell in love with when they joined the show back in 1977. Please welcome Roger and David, the Otwell twins. Hi, guys.
Hey. Hi.
Boy, is it good to see you.
It's great to see you.
What do you think when you look back at this show?
Oh, the most funnest times, I guess, ever in our lives. I just loved it. I just wish it would go on forever. It's terrific.
it was kind of like a fairy tale. Amazing, you know, to be on the Lawrence Welk show. And how fun was that, though? I mean, it was just great.
Now, which one's older?
Roger, I can tell, you know, just about.
only 13,
by how much?
13 minutes.
Okay. So. Now, did you always sing? Were you from a musical family?
Yes, and I remember when we were kids and we lived on the farm, even like 6 years old, we wrote our first song and we were singing, but Mom and Dad both sang.
And then our sister, she's quite a bit older than us, about 16 years, but she was invited on the Arthur Godfrey show and never did it because she was just, you know, graduating from high school, gonna get married. And I think she really helped us, you know, always working with us, saying, okay, or helping us with the harmony thing.
And encouraging.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And,
okay, so how did you get on the Lawrence Welk show?
You know, it was so amazing. There was a man in Tulia by the name of Jack Love, and at that time the governor of Texas was Dolph Briscoe, and we had done the show for the governor. He came to town, and Jack was talking with him, and the governor said, you know, these guys really ought to be on the Lawrence Welk show.
So, we're always hearing, well, how do you do that?
Sure.
Jack starts checking it out, and he finds out he's a businessman, so he finds out that Lawrence's business manager is Ted Lennon's, the Lennon sister's uncle. So, you know, Mr. Welk gets, 300 tapes a day, you know.
And he sent the tape to Ted Lennon. Ted never got tapes.
So Ted listens to it, he likes it, walks right into Mr. Welk's office, plays the tape. We get a phone call. It's Mr. Welk.
He
on
said,
the phone. We thought it was
I'll never
joke.
Forget, because he said, hello, guess who this is?
No idea. Boy, you talk about being excited. And I think it was like at noon, and we were going to college, but we were also working, and we just happened to be home, and we're both just, flipping out, you know. And so he wants us to be on the show, you know, to go out to California and do a guest shot.
So he brought you out without an audition?
No audition.
Just the tape?
Just
mm-hmm.
the tape.
Wow. And I understand the whole town of Tulia got into the act to get you to California.
Oh, yeah. We did a little show, and there were just tons of people, because we were from a fairly poor family, you know, so there were tons of people that donated or, you know, helped, you know, to get
they
us.
They even had a Otwell Twins Day, like a proclamation from the mayor. But anyway, we raised enough money to go, and we were so excited. And
well, didn't the postmaster?
Oh, at the time, the girl that I was dating, her dad was the postmaster, and so when the letter came, Mr. Welk's picture's on the envelope, you know, and it was all over town before we even got the letter, you know. So
somebody, in fact, I was working at a men's clothing store, and some lady came in. She says, "Oh, I'm so excited about the letter," and I said, "What letter?" She says, "Oh, you haven't seen the..." So it was going around town.
So everybody knew before you did.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
So how did you happen to get teamed with the girls, Sheila and Sherry?
Well, you know, Mr. Welk, when he hired us, he had already hired the girls, 3 weeks before we got out there. So
and there was one spot on the show. And
two acts.
Yeah, and two acts. So he told us... He told us about Sheila and Sherry, and of course we just wanted to know if they were pretty or not. You know, and he's like, "Oh yes, they're very pretty." You know, and
I think though that it was George Cates' idea.
Yeah.
He said, "What if we put them together as a quartet?" So George takes us in and he says, "Sing something together." You know, we just barely met each other.
We're like, Rod and I said, "Let's do Shenandoah." So we did, and somehow our voices all blended together really well. It was really a pretty good mix, you know, So we did that song, and they're like, "Okay, that's it." So we were a group.
and the girls
loved
were,
group.
Yeah. Oh, we had a blast, and the girls were fantastic. And,
sweet.
You know.
So what did you do when the weekly show ended?
Oh, you know, we immediately, we were going to play in Gatlinburg, and at that time the World's Fair was going on in Knoxville, but we had most a couple of months off, so we packed everything up and we moved everything back to Tulia, Texas, our hometown, and stored it. And then we went on to Gatlinburg, Tennessee, and we were there for, I don't know, 6 or 8 months, with Ava and Roger and Guy
was there,
and Jim Turner came occasionally. He was
and
doing
Joy Schmidt, and we had a blast, and we'd water ski every day, and then do the show at night. And we did a show every night, but then, as soon as that ended, David and I moved to Nashville, and I was married at that time. Millie and I had gotten married the last year of the show, so we were, really excited. Nashville is such a beautiful city and a big difference from L.A. So it for about a year there, it took us a long time, but we kind of got hooked up with the Nashville Network. And we were never regulars, but we were on the Nashville Now show sometimes 3 or 4 times a month, and we did that for like nearly 3 years, and we did a lot. We'd be on the road.
We were touring with Ferlin Husky and Sheb Woolley and the Hager twins from Hee-Haw.
Yeah.
That was a great pair-up. Wow, we had fun with those guys. So. But it was nothing was as great as the Welk show.
No.
And our friends.
But it was, we had a blast. And so we do that and then eventually we've moved, back to Amarillo, Texas. And we were still doing shows on the road. We had
the girls were, homesick, and I'd married Leslie at that time. And we were sometimes on the road 2 and 3 months at a time. So it was a lot more comfortable for them to be, back in Texas than to be in Nashville. They didn't really know anyone. And
sure.
So we moved back.
I think a lot of it had to do with the local KACV PBS in Amarillo, because they were calling us, wanting us to do, and we did a lot of different things for them, a lot of different, I think we even brought in like Joe Finney and Ava and I don't know who all for the Civic Center in Amarillo, a bunch of the people from the show. And then we did a little show in a theater in the round that they taped and aired.
So you were back in the swing of things. What are you doing now?
Well, now we have real jobs.
We own a little filter company called El Dorado, but it runs United Filters, basically, and it's in United has a plant in Mexico, so I have to go there a lot, and then we sell filters, or actually I do, to the oil and gas and chemical processing industry and water filtration, and I run that operation, and then Roger runs a cotton warehouse.
I run North Plains Cotton Compress in Tulia, Texas. Live in Amarillo, so my wife and I drive back and forth every day, so we're in the cotton business and the filtration.
And you've got wonderful
business.
Families.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah.
Roger and Millie have been married. They just celebrated their 25th anniversary, and Leslie and I will celebrate ours next May.
So. Oh, fabulous.
But we don't have kids, and he does.
I have a 21-year-old daughter, Rachel, who some of the folks may remember her on one of the shows we shot in Branson. She was 11. We did a...
She's singing. Yeah.
I think that scared her to death, so she's not singing, but she's just great. And our son Adam will be 13 in September, and he's playing the guitar and been in a couple of plays. And
following in Dad's footsteps.
Yeah, you bet.
Oh, I'm so glad we had this time to visit. It's wonderful to see you again.
Well, it's wonderful to see you.
Yes.
And thanks for spending another week with us. As Lawrence Welk always said, keep a song in your heart.